everyone. We'd like to welcome everyone to the 2020 Amherst State of the Schools program. And the State of Schools program is a little bit different than what we originally intended. Our hope initially was to provide the State of the Schools in a setting that was open to the public here at Powers Elementary School, and then would be followed by tours of our new Powers Elementary. But like with so many other things, we have had to adjust and improvise and make adjustments due to the COVID pandemic. And we appreciate and thank you for your patience and flexibility with us. First and foremost, I want to thank our community for your support, your words, your emails, your text messages of encouragement through this very difficult and challenging time. Your encouragement means a great deal to our staff as we've worked our way through this situation. Secondly, I would like to thank our students. Our students were forced to adjust to a new way of learning with very little notice, and you have done just a phenomenal job over these last several weeks. And as a school district, I can't begin to express how proud of you we really are in the way that you've handled this, again, very difficult and challenging situation. And finally, I want to thank our Amherst staff. I've always said that the Amherst community, the Amherst staff, is at its best during times of adversity and going through trials and difficult circumstances. And once again, you've stepped up, and everyone has rallied together to make the best of this, and we truly appreciate it. I've just been so impressed with the way our staff has responded with creative lessons and how much they have reached out to stay engaged and connected to our students. And I thought this would be a good time to share just one example of how our staff has reached out to express their care and concern for our students.
I miss seeing each and every one of your smiling faces at school. Keep up the hard work. Stay healthy. I hope we get back to seeing each other in the classroom this school year. I'm so proud of the hard work that all of you are doing. Missing you all so much. Keep up the good work. Sending my hugs.
Even though we're home with our kids and family now, know that we miss and love you too. We'll see you soon. Stay safe.
Last several weeks and plan to utilize over the next 3 or 4 weeks as we finish up the 2019-20 school year. Mike?
Well, thanks, Steve. Obviously, Education Ohio has been different over the last couple months since the COVID-19 situation that we have in Ohio. And we've had to really rely on the things we've had to rely on for many years. We've focused on good communication, home instruction, high quality instruction, and using the resources we have available. This all began really last summer when, with Doug Cogdell, our new technology supervisor, we developed a 5-year technology plan to put technology into the hands of all our students. And we were fortunate to start this current school year with devices 1-to-1, Chromebooks in 3rd grade through 12th grade. So that was just a great start to the school year, and it allowed our students and staff to really become comfortable with technology and using some of the resources we find that we had to use come March. And we focused on those kind of aspects of using Google Hangout and Google Classroom. We used Gmail to communicate. We started expanding more with Zoom when we started this instruction. And so things really, we were really lucky to be a head start of many other school districts. Also, our tech team did a great job of providing a hotline for our students and parents. It's utilized almost every day, and we're grateful for that. And we will probably look at to continue those kinds of developments as we look into the fall for next school year. I just want to thank Doug Cogdell again. Also, Amanda Sears, our technology integration specialist. She did a phenomenal job of supporting our teachers. And just again, overwhelmingly thanking all the teachers and staff for all the work and support they did to really make this home instruction transition really smooth. And again, I think overall, we've learned a lot. I think in the fall, when we continue our education, we're going to incorporate some of these ideas into instruction. I think we've all grown quite a bit. And I think it's just we've done a wonderful job, and I think the community would agree with that. With that, also, we did a survey recently where we've gotten information from the community, and you've given us great feedback. We've had over, I think, 600 responses already, and the feedback has been really positive. You've thought that we've done a really good job educating your students from home in the best situation we can. And again, we look to continue to grow and move forward and just continue to use what we've learned over the last few months in the future of Amherst. So we just thank you again for all your support and help with that. And this time I'm going to turn it back over to Steve for some more updates.
Also wanted to take this opportunity to thank our Nutrition Services Department for their work during this school closure. They have partnered with the Second Harvest Food Bank and over the last several weeks have been able to provide meals and lunches to students and families who were in need, and again, a big shout out to all those who have helped with this project. Also wanted to mention and draw attention to one of our seniors, class of 2020, Dominic Deshook, was actually highlighted in a video during one of Governor DeWine's press conferences. And Dominic, right here from Amherst, Ohio, did a great job of encouraging everyone how to stay safe during this pandemic. I'd like to share Dominic's video with you at this time.
By staying home, I'm keeping myself safe and my family safe as well.
The reason why I'm staying at home is so we can reduce the amount of people needing to go to the hospital and so our healthcare workers are not overworked, and so we can flatten the curve to reduce the amount of deaths due to the corona, and so we can get back to our normal life as quick as possible.
My mom has asthma and had thyroid cancer, which puts her at higher risk of getting the coronavirus. Please stay home and keep us all safe.
I am staying home so I do not risk getting other people sick and so we can get back to normal quicker.
I'm staying home because if we take action now, a better future will come much faster. And we need to protect those who are more susceptible to the virus.
Thank you again, Dominic, for being such a great leader during this difficult time and representing Steele High School and the Amherst School so well. Speaking of the class of 2020, wanted to mention a very neat event that took place here a couple of weeks ago on April 20th at 8:20 p.m., which is 2020 military time. Our stadium lights were illuminated and porch lights were turned on throughout the Amherst community for 20 minutes and 20 seconds to recognize and honor the class of 2020. It was a great event, and we just thank everyone for your participation in that very special event. And speaking again of the class of 2020, I wanted to mention that Joe Tellier, our high school principal, and his team there at the high school is working diligently to provide a very special, memorable, and creative commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. Clearly, this class will go down in the history books of the Amherst Steel class of 2020. And this is a class that many folks will be talking about for many years to come. And we just thank you, Mr. Tellier, and your staff for your work in preparing for this very special event. And now I would like to reintroduce our Assistant Superintendent, Mike Molnar, who's going to share and highlight some other key happenings in our district.
Thanks, Steve. And let me reiterate what Steve mentioned earlier, and that is what a wonderful collective response we had for the community when we had the outbreak. Everyone really pulled together and did a phenomenal job, both students, staff, parents. We just greatly appreciate all you've done for the district and your support. Everyone was flexible and positive, and again, we just thank you so much. And that positivity really started when we opened Powers Elementary School in January. That was, again, a wonderful response from the community. We had a beautiful dedication. What a smooth transition we had. Never before had I seen a building open with everything ready to go for our students. So kudos to Principal Beth Schwartz and all the staff here at Powers Elementary School. And again, what a beautiful facility. We have a great learning environment, movable walls, great open spaces, smaller learning spaces, a full-size gym, just a beautiful space. And we, again, appreciate the community's support in helping us build this wonderful elementary school. Now, as we move forward to next school year, we're really excited about doing what we always do, and that is expanding learning opportunities for students. So we're excited that we're going to expand our Spanish program from K through 12. We're looking forward to that by adding a few teachers there. We're adding some other great teachers as well right now in fourth grade, technology at the high school. We're just so excited as we add new talent to the district and what they can provide for our students. Another thing we are looking forward to, we started last year and just building upon, is just our focus on parent information and mental health. Our Director of Student Services, Sarah Walker, has done a phenomenal job of working with guidance counselors and a social worker, really to focus on the mental health of students and staff, and just providing more information and resources to parents in the community, just so we continue to focus on the whole child and every student in our district. And one thing I do want to mention academically is our Momentum Award. This year, for the fourth year in a row, we earned the Momentum Award from the state of Ohio. And that is because we earned four straight A's in our growth and value added. Norton AJH also got straight A's, and they also earned the Momentum Award. And again, kudos to everyone in the district. We're one of only five school districts to win that award 4 years in a row. So again, it's all because of a great staff, great teachers, great parents, great students, a wonderful community. And we look forward to continuing to build on that next school year. So again, thank you for all your support in that area. Thank you for being a high-achieving district. Thank you to everyone for just doing a wonderful job. And at this time, I'm going to turn it over to Amy Gifredo for a financial update.
Thanks, Mike. Hi, I am Amelia Gifredo, Amherst School's treasurer. I'm here to provide a financial update for the district. As we have stated for the last couple of years, Amherst Schools remains financially stable through at least fiscal year 2023, and that has not changed. We have continually managed our costs. In fact, our per pupil expenditures are about $2,500 less than the state average. According to our state report card, Amherst is in the top 20% in terms of performance, and yet in the bottom 20% in terms of per pupil spending. We strive for that balance, excellence in the classroom, and prudent spending. All our projections could be impacted by the federal or state government, or even locally at any time. If you have watched any of Governor Mike DeWine's press conferences, you have likely heard discussed the dwindling rainy day fund as it pertains to the state's response to the COVID-19 crisis. To say there is uncertainty then regarding state funding for schools would be an understatement, right? So we will produce the May 5-year forecast update along the similar assumptions as we produce the October 2019 forecast. And know that we will likely modify the forecast as we learn more regarding the state financial environment and that of school funding coming forward. So that is why it is important, more important than ever even, to continue to be very prudent and mindful of our expenditures. We will continue to strive for the consistency and accountability that has us in good shape today and then for future years. Thank you. Here's our superintendent again, Mr. Steve Sayers.
Thank you, Amy. And in closing, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank the Amherst community for your ongoing help and support, especially over these last several weeks as we've worked our way through this pandemic situation. We couldn't do what it is we do without you, and we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We'd also encourage everyone to continue to check our website, our Facebook page, as well as emails for updates in terms of what's happening in the district, not only for the remainder of the 2019-20 school year, but also as we look ahead to the 2020-21 school year. Thank you again. Best wishes for a great summer, and go Comets.